it?
Thank you all for coming out today to defend the Constitution, to defend the rule of law. We have your renegade prosecutor right now with no regard for the law, working out his private issues on the public stage and going after a minor, threatening his liberty because of his own personal agenda. This is a rogue prosecutor. This is someone who thinks he's above the law. This is something we cannot put up with. This is still America. This is not Iran. This is not Russia. This is the United States where we believe in freedom. And we are out here today to guarantee liberty and to defend freedom against those who would take it away. Thank you all for coming out here today. And they claim, but I think it's interesting, they claim to be conservative. This is big government religion is what this is, trying to tell people that we're going to prosecute you if you do not believe our way. Is there anything less conservative than that? I don't think so. And they also want to claim it's for Christianity. This isn't about love. This is about lashing out against somebody for no good reason and trying to make a point. We looked at the prosecutors. We looked at the prosecutor, what he said. He said this was about the war on Christmas. This was about liberals. This guy sounds more like a talk show host, like he wants to be Bill O'Reilly or Rush Limbaugh than a district attorney. I say he should go get himself a television or radio show if that's what he's about, rather than somebody who hides behind the law. This is an individual who should be going after crimes, not waging culture war against teenagers. And we are here today again to defend the Constitution, and I am proud to stand with you today, coming in from Chicago, and many of you all came in from all over today to stand up for this country and what makes it great. Thank you very much.
I'm going to see if Dave?
You want me to go next?
Yeah. I don't know if you'll be able to get this to work.
Just go ahead.
Oh, yeah.
Shot.
Yeah.
There's a microphone. Can we attach
it? Right there. Hold it like that. That's fine. It'll pick up. That's
Testing.
Background.
There we go.
Hey, everybody.
You got to stand up a bit.
Can you all hear me?
Yes.
I said, can you all hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for coming out here today to defend the Constitution and a child. I am, unfortunately, let me see if I can find this. I am the anti-Christian, banned school prayer, war on Christmas, opposed the display of the Ten Commandments crowd. And I am proud to be that, because that is how you defend religious liberty. Religious liberty comes from the separation of church and state. And in fact, religious freedom is a synonym for the separation of church and state. Now, what does the separation of church and state mean? It means the government provides a protection for all citizens to practice their religions as they see fit, but does not take sides. Anytime the government takes sides on the practice of religion is a loss, a step closer to theocracy, a step farther away from religious freedom. Think about it. If the government protects one religion over another, if the government gives you an advantage to one religion over another, one religious position over another, that those minority positions get fewer rights. And this is what we're having here. We're seeing a person, a child, who has displayed an opinion. Now, it doesn't matter whether or not we like the opinion. That's not the point. It doesn't matter whether or not we endorse the opinion. That's not the point. However, of course, I do. This is about the ability to express an opinion. This is about the ability to say something, even if it's not right. This is about to express a minority viewpoint, and this is about a district attorney stepping over the line to protect one theology, one religion, to the detriment of the civil rights of a child. And I am here to say something very clear to the district attorney. That's illegal. You can't do that. He came out and said that this was about protecting the religious rights of the people who are praying. And yet all the people who pray in this church, they weren't affected by this. They didn't even know it happened. Nobody knew it happened until the child posted pictures. So how are any human's rights trampled? They're not. What has been trampled is the idea that Christianity is above reproach and above criticism. I criticize religion. I deny the Holy Spirit and God, and I encourage all of you to do so, and this is the number one worst crime in Christianity. And I am here to tell the district attorney to pick on someone your own size. Use the exact same reasoning you used to throw this child into the penal system, to attack me and to arrest me, because I stand by my conviction that religion is a scam, that Jesus is a lie, and that God is a myth. And I will shout that from the rooftops. And if somebody gets offended by that, too bad, because I still have the right to say it, and I will continue to use that right and to protect that right, not only for me, but for every citizen of Bedford County and America. Thank you all for coming to this event, and thank you for standing up for the freedom to express religious dissent. Thank you.
Does this work?
You gotta hold it real close.
Is this working? Is this working?
Is it?
Is it working?
Push the thingy.
Working?
Is there like a trigger there?
Yeah, there's a trigger.
Is this working?
No.
No? I'm pulling the trigger.
It's locked in.
Hello?
You ran out of battery.
Yeah, it might have ran out of battery. It didn't work right.
As it's already been said, this is about protecting free speech. This rally is about this child whose rights were violated, his right to express himself, his right to express an opinion that some people find offensive. Those rights were violated. This is not about someone's right to believe or to express their belief. Those rights have not been violated here. This child deserves the right to be able to express himself, just like any other of us. And the minute that the government tells us that we can't express ourselves is the minute the tyranny reigns. And we have to avoid that, and that's why we're here today. We want to make sure that everyone's rights are protected, not just this child and not however you may feel about what he said, but everybody here has the right to express what's on their mind without the law interfering. So I do want to thank everyone that's here today, and it's wonderful to see such a great turnout. And I hope you stick around for a while, and thank you so much. Woo!
Yeah. Thank you.
And we'll take questions in turn from the press. If you guys have questions.
Why don't you let him walk across the street and run his mouth?
I'm sorry?
It's his
Why
choice.
Why don't you let him walk across the street and say something?
We're having our own protest here. I don't think that's relevant to the conversation.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Let who walk across the street and say
the
what?
The point it posed on the statue of Jesus standing right there.
I would have posed on the
statue. So? He expressed his views. He's allowed to do that.
And he's been nothing but trouble in the town of Everett.
That's not the point. He's expressing his views. If he breaks the law, he should be punished. If he doesn't break the law, he has to be defended.
He's a troublemaker. He's nothing but trouble.
So
that's a really great, that's a
we'll
nothing statement.
From the press.
Let's throw the kid in jail. Crying out loud.
Exactly.
Come on. Give me something.
Okay. Hold up.
What law has he broken?
Do you guys have
for what's his name?
What law has he broken?
Okay, that's fine. That's
read everything that has been stated on this point.
Name a law that he has broken.
Name a law he's broken?
Name one.
I don't know the exact name.
There are none.
I know the gentleman right at the camera right next to you does.
But there is no law. The United States Constitution guarantees the right to express. You have to understand.
Trust me, walk up there. Walk up there. I don't want you to hear me.
I think you should know what I called you a queer. What's that mean?
You called me a what?
Queer.
Called me a queer.
I think he means you're unusual.
That's supposed to offend.
No, that's somebody right in here.
I'm
not the country.
My point is, the American Nazi Party exists, and I hate them.
You've been in the military. 21 years.
Then you're a damn disgrace to the country.
I'm a disgrace to the country.
Yeah, you are.
You're an enemy of the Constitution, sir.
Am I?
You're against free speech.
No, I'm not against free speech.
You're against free speech that offends you.
I'm against ignorant little pricks that like to pose on a statue of Jesus.
What does it matter? Speech.
What does it matter what the
free
statute
speech is?
Was?
Speech that you don't agree you. With.
Sure.
Free speech is speech that pisses you off.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
I have a freedom of speech, and I'm wearing it right now.
To come after you instead.
Yeah. So,
you're willing to go and do the same act the kid did?
Because you disagree with it, right? You're going
to
decide.
We can take a trip to Everett, and I can record you.
No, I'm not going to take a picture of the statue of Jesus.
What I'm saying,
he's come out with an extra statement that says that this is about protecting the rights of religion and religious people. The number one law in Christianity. Number one law is thou shalt not blaspheme the name of God.
Learn how to read the law.
I do that. I shall not only blaspheme the name of God and his fake Savior, but I will also encourage others to do so. This is the number one worst thing you can do in Christianity. And if that doesn't offend the sensibilities more than some kid taking a picture that the guy doesn't like with the statue, I don't know what will. So I dare him to use the same grounds that he's using to defend the incarceration of his child.
Okay, first of all, that should be correct. The district attorney here has stated to this media source he is not after 2 years in prison.
That doesn't matter.
He doesn't even know where that came from.
That doesn't matter. The maximum penalty for the crime for which he's charged is 2 years. The district attorney doesn't know what the judge is going to give him. The district attorney was wrong there.
Are you reneging on your previous statement when you said you're challenging him to come after you instead of a child? Yeah. The only way he can properly do that is to duplicate what the child has done.
No, I'm doing it any way I can.
So you're not willing to go to Everett and jump on a statue of Jesus and hump it and see if he'll charge you?
I don't agree with the statement. Okay. I don't agree with the fact that he did that.
Okay.
I agree with his right to do it. Right. Okay, and I'm not going to do that because I don't agree with the statement. But I agree with his right to make the statement. That's a big difference.
Okay.
And we all should agree with his right to make the statement.
So you yourself wouldn't hump a statue of Jesus?
I wouldn't hump a statue of Jesus, no.
Okay.
But if I did, it would be my right.
Right, okay.
Okay? And I am trying to make it worse or better for the DA.
Well, I'm glad you clarified
that. I am openly defying the Holy Spirit, openly defying him to put me up on charges of offending Christianity. Let's do it. Let's bring it to trial. Because that's what this is about. He has said so right off the bat. This is about offending the church and offending religion. I offend religion. I hate religion. I think religion should go away, and I think God is fake, and I defy and deny the Holy Spirit. This is the worst thing you can do in Christianity. I dare him to put me in jail for it.
Have you guys hired an attorney for the kid?
No, we are not representing the child.
Well, I know you're not representing him, but
we have a team of attorneys at the ready to do what needs to be done.
Has he asked for help?
He has not.
I'm not claiming. I never claimed.
You were in the military, correct?
Yeah. Do you know if he's taking a plea bargain?
I hope he does not, because that admits guilt, and he is not guilty.
Do you know what the word adjudicated means?
That you have
word adjudicated?
Yeah.
What do you want? You don't make what about it?
I would defend you.
Tell me what it means. Tell me what you think it means. I'm asking you if you know what the termination of adjudicated.
I'm not going to play word games for you. What do you want?
That's what I am. That's what I'm asking.
Okay.
Do you know what adjudicated means?
No, go ahead.
Oh, okay. That's just the question I asked. If you don't know what it means, maybe you should look it up.
Okay. Now, I read the Bible. I was brought up Christian and all that. And I know it says in the Bible that you're not supposed to make statues of Jesus in the Bible.
Second commandment, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven images of anything that is in heaven.
Or
so
blood,
the statue is against the second commandment.
Yes.
Depending on what version of Christianity you use.
Yes.
If you use the Catholic Bible, it's not against the law because they took it out.
Yeah, I see.
Okay, they took that commandment out because they're all about graven images. If you look at the Protestant Bible and the Christian Bible, it's commandment number two. You can't have a graven image of anything that is in heaven, like a statue of Jesus.
Exactly. Yeah, that's just a statue. It's not Jesus. And if Jesus, I feel, it says in their Bible not to build statues, and they, I don't know.
Of course it does. But every theist in this country is a cafeteria theist, okay? Every religionist is a cafeteria religionist. They pick and choose what they want to obey, and they call it law. That's why they make statues of graven images of things that are in heaven, because they want to. Okay? There's no reason. It's against their laws. It's clearly against their laws. Well, but they want to, so they do. And then they say that this child has
broken, has upset Christianity and offended Christianity, and it's very similar to what we see in ISIS. You know, you
exactly.
are not performing. You are not performing your religion to the way we want you to. Therefore, we're going to put you in jail.
Yes.
It's the same mentality.
Yes.
And this is why blasphemy speech must be allowed.
Exactly. Thank you.
Nothing.
Yeah, I gotta get this Christian.
It's all so you don't like him, so it's not speech.
He's nothing but trouble when you're going to sit there and cause trouble in a town.
Is he an American? American?
He thinks. No, that ain't no American.
Yeah, he's an American.
Oh, okay, so now you're deciding who it is and is not American.
Dude, you're going to keep putting words
you. Back off of me now before you get dropped.
Oh, okay. Violence. There you go.
Back off.
Ooh.
Can we you ain't nothing but a worthless piece of shit. Get back up on the sidewalk where you belong. Get back up on the sidewalk where you belong.
Threaten me again, I'm calling the police.
Get back up on the sidewalk where you belong.
You're not. Do we need to call the police? It
belongs to us too, maybe.
Really?
No, he just threatened.
He just physically threatened.
He just physically threatened.
I told him to back off.
Yeah, you
better learn how to listen. That is not a threat.
You physically threatened him. And if you keep doing it, we are calling the police.
The two state troopers just drove by. What do you think they're going to do? Checking you guys out.
Oh, I'm sure.
Bill.